When combining data from different sources, you may find data exists at different grains. For example, sales happen on a specific day, the day grain, and sale targets are set by month, the month grain. When you want to compare sales to target, you need to be able to roll up those daily sales properly to the monthly level. Knowing how to do this will result in accurate results by avoiding double counting. In this video, you'll see how to avoid double counting by defining how totals should be rolled up. This is the report that we're going to develop in the video to demonstrate how totals get rolled up, when they're wrong, and how we correct them. In this video, I'm using the Coffee Samples and Marketing Data module. Before demonstrating what double counting looks like, I had to make a couple of changes to the data module. One of the things I had to do was add a relationship between dates and sales targets, because what I want to use is the month in dates to roll up my sales receipts to compare against my sales targets. To add the relationship to sales target, I had to create a year value in that table. I did that by adding a calculation, which I hard-coded to 2019 because I know that's what all my sales receipts are for. Once that was done, I could then join my month ID to my target month and my year ID to the target year. I saved my data module in the My Content because I didn't want to impact the samples version. To demonstrate what double counting looks like, I created this simple report using the 2x2 template. In my top left, I dragged the sales month and sales from the sales receipt table. And in the bottom left, in the targets, I dragged target month and total goal from sales targets. In the bottom right, I want to create a list report where I'm going to compare my actuals to targets. But this time I'm going to pick up month ID from the dates table. I'm going to apply the currency data format like I did in the actuals, just for consistency. You can see that my sales values do in fact line up with what my actual sales are, but my total goal in this table doesn't line up with the total goal that I created in to the left. And the reason why that is that the double counting is occurring, and for every day that I have an actual sale, my total goal is getting counted as well. So in fact, for month 4, that value is 30 times the value that's showing in the left column. To correct that, I need to go back to my data module and define some column dependencies. So in the dates, what I need to do is drag out the values that will be used to build my hierarchy. So the year, the month, and the date. And then I start to connect them up. Month rolls up to year. And the date rolls up to the month. Saving that change in my data module, I can now come back to my report. In reports, I can refresh the data module, see that the value hasn't changed yet, but what I need to do then is run the report. After running the report, I can see that double counting is no longer occurring. This concludes the video on avoiding double counting. You've seen how specifying column dependencies allows you to show data at different grains side by side correctly. Documentation for IBM Cognos Analytics with Watson is available online. The video description below contains links for topics covered in this video. If you would like to try what was demonstrated in this video, you will find the data in the samples folder in Team Content.